press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello everyone. In the last class, we have discussed the meaning of history and the types of history we have discussed in the last period. The students, when sometimes you got wounded, sometimes you got any prize, the people may ask to you, when did you get, how did you get, where did you get, or you got wounded, when did you get wound, how did you get wound, and where did you get wound. These are all the questions which are arising in our everyday life. You have to answer all these questions, those whom asked to you. How, when, and where. The history is going along with the dates. The dates are very important when we study the history. Whenever you won the prize in kabaddi, kokko, or any other matches, the people ask, how did you get? You may answer, I defeated the enemies and I got this prize. When did you get? You may answer, yesterday I got this prize. Where did you get? You may answer the place name which the prize was got by you. These are all the questions which clearly expresses the dates. The dates are very important when we study the history. In this session, we are going to learn the eighth standard. The first lesson is how, when, and where. How, when, and where, which means how did it take place, when did it take place, where did it take place. There are three questions which are arising the history. The first lesson, shall I move? Okay. Teaching points. The first one is, how important are dates? Which dates? How do we periodize? What is colonial? How do we know? Administration, producers, records. Surveys become important. What officials, records do not tell? How important are dates? The first point we are going to learn, the first part is, how important are dates? There was a time when historians were fascinated with dates, which means there was a time when historians, which means those who write history, they are called as historians. Example, Herodotus, Jawaharlal Nehru, Mujumdar Shah, these are all called historians. Historians, those who write history, they are called as historians. Fascinated with dates, which means the historians attracts with the dates. They were writing history along with the dates. That's why the dates are very important when we study the history. There were heated debates about the dates. On which rulers were crowned, which battles were fought. There was a time when historians, they were writing history along with the dates, which means fascinated with dates. There were heated debates about the dates. On which rulers were crowned. Crowned means coronation, which means yavaga pattabhishekavanna madidaru. For examples, Ashoka, when did he crown? Ashoka was crowned in the era of 268. And next, the Babur, who was the famous king of Mughal Empire, he was crowned in 1526. And Akbar, he was the grandson of Babur, the famous king of, the prominent king of Mughal Empire, he was crowned 1556. And next, so many rulers, when were crowned? Along when we study the crown, we have to keep it on our mind, dates are very important. Which battles were fought? Battles which means clashes, like wars. Which battles were fought between? The battle which took place between Prithviraj Chauhan and Muhammad Ghazni. 1191, the battle name is Tarain Battle. The first Tarain Battle which took place between Prithviraj Chauhan and next one is Muhammad bin Tughal, sorry, Muhammad Ghori. And second Tarain Battle next year, 1192, took place between Prithviraj Chauhan and Muhammad Ghori. Which battles were fought? And next, the famous Narmada Battle which took place between Harshavardhana and Dakshinapateshwara, was popularly known as Dakshinapateshwara, Himmadi Pulakeshi or Pulakeshi II, on the banks river of Narmada. Where? On the banks river of Narmada. How was taken place? The battle took place between Harshavardhana and next one is Himmadi Pulakeshi. Which battles were fought and which rulers were crowned? Heated debates about the dates on which rulers were crowned, which battles were fought. I have given so many examples. In the common sense of notion, common sense of notion, history was synonymous with dates, which means history equals dates, which means history, whenever we study the history, the dates are very important to study the history. You may have people say, always say, I find is history boring because it is all about memorizing dates. Whenever the some people are students, they tell history boring, history is find boring. Why it is history boring? Because it is all about the memorizing dates. Is such a conception true? Why is history boring? Because one more question, why is history boring? It is all about memorizing dates. How do you say that? When was Harappa civilization born? Mohenjo-daro civilization born? When did Ashoka crown? Next, when did Carnatic take place? When did Anglo-Mysore war take place? When did Anglo-Maratha war take place? 1747 to 1748, first Carnatic War took place. 1749 to 56, second Carnatic War took place. 1759 to 64, third Carnatic War took place. And first Anglo-Mysore War, 1767 to 69, first, second Anglo-Mysore War, 1780 to 84. Third 1790 to 92, fourth 1799. These are all the question, oh my God, I find history is boring because it is all about memorizing dates. In such a conception too, history equals dates. History which means dates. Dates are very important when we studying the history. History is, what is history? History is certainly about changes that occur over a period of time. It is about finding out how things were in the past and how things have changed. History is certainly about changes that occur over a period of time, which means history is not suddenly changes. History is certainly about changes that occur over a period of time. When was tea introduced in India? Today we drink so many teas: black tea, red tea, green tea. We are drinking so many various teas. But when was tea started in India? Whatever the things in history is certainly about changes that occur over a period of time. It is about finding out past, present. How things were in the past? How do you say that history is certainly about changes that occur over a period of time? One more question. It is about finding out how things were in past, how things were in past, how things have changed. How things have changed. In the earlier days, the people, they wore leaves. In the BCE era, the people use in India leaves. Leaves means elegalanna muchkolta idu. And the certain changes, day by day, people use. In the last 18th century, the people of India, they have owned panche shirt, and women, they used sari. But nowadays, we are looking present world modernization, that everything changes, food style, lifestyle, and next dress style, there are number of things changes. How things were in the past and how things have changed. As soon as we compare the past with the present, we refer to time, we talk of before and after. History is about changes that occur over a period of time, which means how things were in the past and how things have changed. We compare the past with the present. Example, how did the people wear clothes in the past? How people do wear in the present? ಅವಾಗ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಧರಿಸಿದ್ರು ಬಟ್ಟೆಯನ್ನು, ಇವಾಗ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಧರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ವಿಚ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ದ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್. ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಆ್ಯಪನ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್. ಮಾಡರ್ನೈಸೇಷನ್, ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದ ಮಾಡರ್ನೈಸೇಷನ್, ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲೈಸೇಷನ್, ಅರ್ಬನೈಸೇಷನ್, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್. ವಿ ರೆಫರ್ ಟು ಟೈಮ್, ವಿ ಟಾಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್. ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್, ಅಂಡ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್. Before and after, past, presents. Do you understand? History is certainly about changes that occur over a period of time. How do you say that? How things were in the past and how things have changed. We compare the history with present, we refer to time, we talk of before and after. How important are date? Leaving the world, we do not ask always historical questions about what we see around us. We take things for granted. Leaving the world, we do not always ask historical questions. We have many things seen around of us: bridge, castle, mountain, street, road, fence, tree, forest, flowers, cloud, sun, grass. Leaving the world, we do not ask the questions: when was tree founded, when did tree find, when did tree grow, where did first tree grow, and next to how did tree form, and next bridge, when was first bridge built? Where was first bridge built? And how was first built bridge? We do not always ask historical questions about what we see around us. Nama suttamutta irthakkanta things galanna naavu endu questions anna haakalla. We take things for granted, which means we accept the situation without question around of us. We take things for granted, as if what we see has always been in the world we inhabit. Now, yen sutamudha nortidivo avellavu kuda ange irthava, adru kuda naavu illi vaasa maartta idivi. How important are dates? But most of us have our moments of wonder. When we are curious, our life is wonder. When we are curious and we ask questions that actually are historical, When we ask questions, which means when did people begin to drink tea? When was railways built? The questions that actually are historical. When it becomes actually historical? When are actually becomes historic, become historical? When we ask the question that actually are historical. Watching someone sip a cup of tea and roadside tea stall, you may wonder. Daily you see roadside, there are number of people who gather and they sip a cup of tea at a roadside tea stall. You may wonder, when did people begin to drink tea or coffee? Don't you know? Yeah, you may wonder, the people sip a cup of tea at roadside tea stall. You may wonder, when did people begin to drink tea or coffee? When did people begin to drink tea or coffee? You don't you know, the first tea drank in the era of, the first people began to drink tea in the year of 1�     The first tea was introduced in Assam. Assam tea is very famous. Or coffee. Coffee, the first coffee which was introduced in Baba Budangiri of Karnataka. The first MN saint who came to India and he planted the coffee plant in the Baba Budangiri hills nearby Chikkamangaluru. The Karnataka is famous for coffee, tea is famous for Assam. When did people begin to drink tea? Whenever the tea was started and coffee was started, people drank tea. And next one is, nowadays we have to see, we are seeing there are many teas and many coffee companies are there in around of us. How important are dates? Look out the window of train, you may ask yourself. Whenever you journey from Mangalore to Bangalore, look at the window of train, you may ask yourself, when were railways built? 1853, the father of railway, Lord Dalhousie, he was the Governor General of English. The first, he built the railways in 1853. When were railways built? Where were railways built? First railways built, Mumbai to Thane, 60 April 1853, 30 kilometer. First Mumbai to Thane. Lord Dalhousie was the father of railways because he first built railways in India. Therefore, he was called as father of railway. When were railways built? How did people travel long distance before the age of railway? Students, you may ask the question, how did people travel long distance before the age of railways? The people traveled with using of buses before railway, and some they were using bull cart. These are all the things had been used before the age of railways. That means railway barakinta munche people long travel avadraga maartiddanta heli. Reading the newspaper in the morning, you may be curious to know. One is coffee. When was tea started in India? When were railways built? Railways were built in 1853, built by Lord Dalhousie. Where? Mumbai to Thane. When? 1853. How? The first which was started by Lord Dalhousie. Reading the newspaper in the morning, you may be curious to know. There are number of people in newspapers who comes to your home. Samyukta Karnataka, Vijay Karnataka, the Indian newspaper, Hindustan. There are a number of people. There are a number of paper you can see in the morning. The people reading the newspaper, when did the people start read newspaper? Reading the newspaper in the morning, you may be curious to know how people got to hear about things before newspaper began to be printed. How people got to hear before the newspaper, things before newspaper began to be printed. These are all the questions which arise in your mind. Which is the first newspaper of India? The Bengal Gazette, which was the first newspaper of India. It was started in the year of 1780. James Augustus Icky, he was the founder of newspaper in India, 1780. 1937, the first newspaper of Karnataka, the Mangaluru Samachara is the first newspaper of Karnataka. How people got to hear about things before newspaper began to be printed? They use birds from communication through the bird from one place to another place. Look at the page number 1, figure 1. Brahmins offering the Shastras to Britannia. Brahmins, which means the Prestige class of people. There are 4 types of people: Brahmanas, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas, Shudras, according to Veda. Offering andre salisadare Shastra to Britannia. Shastras, frontispiece to the first map produced by James Rennell, 1792. Who was produced first map in India? James Rennell, who started first newspaper in India. Rennell was asked by Robert Clive to produce maps of Hindustan. Robert Clive, he asked Rennell, you have to prepare the map. I have to see how many area which was occupied by East India Company. An enthusiastic supporter of British conquest of India. Who was Robert Clive? Robert Clive was the Governor General of East India Company of India. He came to India. He waged war. Battle of Plassey, Battle of Buxar, First, Second and Third Carnatic War. He established his kingdom and he extended his British Empire all over the India. He asked to Rennell, you have to prepare the map. Therefore, Rennell, he prepared the Indian map. Who prepared the first Indian map of India? Rennell. An enthusiastic supporter of British conquest of India, Rennell saw preparation of maps as essential to the process of domination. Rennell saw preparation. Why did he start? Maps are as essential to the process of domination. Domination, which means Nama Shakti Estide, India Ali, is to now how many places we have occupied. There he wanted to see the land which was occupied by East India Company. That's why he has ordered to Rennell, you have to prepare the map. Therefore, Rennell, he had prepared the first map. The picture here tries to suggest the Indians willingly gave over their ancient text to Britannia. Domination, the picture which is clearly showing the ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬಗ್ಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥವ್ರು ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ಸು, ಅವರು ಡೊಮಿನೇಷನ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಡೊಮಿನೇಷನ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷರಿಗೆ ಬಗ್ಗಿ ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಬಗ್ಗಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಅವರ ಕೈ ಕೆಳಗೆ ಶಕ್ತಿ ನಿಮಗಿಂತ ಕಡಿಮೆ, ನಾವು ಶಕ್ತಿಯುತರಾಗಿದೆ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಅವರನ್ನು ತೋರಿಸು. ವಿಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ಲಿ ಗೇವ್ ಓವರ್ ದೇರ್ ಏನ್ಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ಬ್ರಿಟಾನಿಯಾ. ದೇರ್ ಏನ್ಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವೇದಿಕ್ ಕಲ್ಚರ್, ವೇದ, ಉಪನಿಷತ್, ಋಗ್ವೇದ ಯಜುರ್ವೇದ ಅಥರ್ವಣ ವೇದ, ದೀಸ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ವೇದಸ್ ವಿಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ಲಿ ಗೇವ್ ಓವರ್ ದೇರ್ ಏನ್ಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬ್ರಿಟಾನಿಯಾ, ದ ಸಿಂಬಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಪವರ್, ಆಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಹರ್ ಟು ಬಿಕಮ್ ದ ಪ್ರೊಟೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಕಲ್ಚರ್. ದ ಸಿಂಬಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಪವರ್, ಆಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಅರ್ ಟು ಬಿಕಮ್ ದ ಪ್ರೊಟೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಕಲ್ಚರ್. ನೀವು ನಮ್ಮ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಕಲ್ಚರ್ನ ಪ್ರೊಟೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಂತಂದೇಳಿ ಹೇಳಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದನ್ನು ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ಬೋದು. ನೋ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ಡ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೌ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆರ್ ಡೇಸ್ಟ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಈಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಸರ್ಟೈನ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ದಟ್ ಅಕ್ಕರ್ ಓವರ್ ಎ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಹೌ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಹೌ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟು ಸಮ್ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಆಲ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟಾರಿಕಲ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್. ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ದಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟಾರಿಕಲ್. ಹೌ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡೇಟ್ಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯೂರಿಯಸ್ ವಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ದಟ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಆರ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟಾರಿಕಲ್. ವೆನ್ ಡಿಡ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಬಿಗಿನ್ ಟು ಡ್ರಿಂಕ್ ಟೀ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವೆನ್ ಡಿಡ್ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಬಿಗಿನ್ ಟು ಡ್ರಿಂಕ್ ಕಾಫಿ. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಮೇ ಆಸ್ಕ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆನ್ ವರ್ ರೈಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಬಿಲ್ಟ್ ವೆನ್ ವರ್ ನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಪೇಪರ್ ಬಿಗ್ಯಾನ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಪ್ರಿಂಟೆಡ್. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಅರೈಸಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಸಚ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟಾರಿಕಲ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ರೆಫರ್ ಅಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ನೋಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಬಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್. ಆಲ್ ಸಚ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟಾರಿಕಲ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ರೆಫರ್ ಅಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ನೋಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಆ ಒಂದು ಕಾಲಕ್ಕೆ ನಮ್ಮನ್ನು ಕರೆದೊಯ್ಯುತ್ತದೆ. ಬಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಸೈಸ್ಲಿ ಡೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಇಯರ್ ಆರ್ ಎ ಮಂತ್. ಬಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಸೈಸ್ಲಿ ಡೇಟೆಡ್ ಅಂದರೆ ವಿ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ವಾರ್ ಟುಕ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಕಿಂಗ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಸನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಈ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಅಸೆಂಡೆಡ್ ಥ್ರೋನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಈ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಬೀನ್ ಡೆಟ್ರೋನ್ಡ್ ಈ ವಾಸ್ ಕಿಲ್ಡ್. ವಿ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಪ್ರಿಸೈಸ್ಲಿ ಡೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಇಯರ್ ಆರ್ ಮಂತ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಬಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಸೈಸ್ಲಿ ಡೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಇಯರ್ ಆರ್ ಮಂತ್. ಸಮ್ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಸೈಸ್ ಡೇಟಸ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸಸ್ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಓವರ್ ಎ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. ವೈ ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ಕರೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವಿ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ history is that the process that happen over a period of time, it is not suddenly changes. One question, sometimes it is usually incorrect to fix precise dates. Why? The processes that happen over a period of time, it is not suddenly changes. The things, it has not been suddenly changed. It changes, it took over a period of time. Example, the railways, when were railways built? As we know that, 1853. Who built? Lord Dalhousie. The first railway, Ugi Yantragalu antale karididru. Nowadays, we may see the electrical railway. And next, before 15 years, there was a keypad mobiles are there. Nowadays, we are using touchpad mobiles, internet, whatever the things, there are number of things are there in the mobile. Why do we not fix that precise date to the history? Because processes that happen over a period of time. People in India did not begin drinking tea one fine day. When did people in India start? People in India did not begin drinking tea one fine day. They developed as a taste over a period of time. First they drank, after look at the board. The first time tea, and next there can be no one clear date for a process such as this. Ivella agirudu no one clear date for a process such as this. Similarly, we cannot fix one singular date on British which British rule was established. அதே தர வி கெனாட் ஃபிக்ஸ் ஒன் சிங்கிள் டேட் ஆன் விச் பிரிட்டிஷ் ரூல் வாஸ் எஸ்டாப்ளிஷ்டு. லிசன், வென் டிட் த பிரிட்டிஷ் கம் டு இந்தியா? ஆக்சுவலி தெர் இஸ் நோ பர்டிகுலர் டேட். 1600 த குவீன் எலிஜபெத் ஹூ கிராண்டட் த பர்மிஷன் டு ட்ரேட் ஈஸ்ட் இண்டியா கம்பெனி வித்தின் 15 இயர்ஸ் இன் த இயர் ஆஃப் 1600. த பிரிட்டிஷ் ஹூ ஹேட் கம் டு இந்தியா and the first warehouse started at Surat in 1630, and next 1639 they purchased Madras from the king of Chandragiri. They built St. George port, and one city grew up that is named Madras. Like this British, they had been developing for hundred of years. We cannot fix one single date on which British rule was established or the national movement was started. When we come to the national movement, when was it started? We don't know. There are number of dates. The national movement which was started, we can classify three types of national movements. The first, 1885 to, listen to me correctly, 1885 to 1905, this is the age is called as radical age. 1905 to 1950, this is the age is called as revolutionary age. 1947 is called as Gandhi, era of Gandhi. The national movement which was started from 1857, the Sipahi first mutiny. The national movement was started. Changes took place within the economy and society. When was first economy started and society started? All these things happened over a stretch of time. We can only a span of time. The national movement when was started? 1857, 1885 to 1905 to 1920, 1920 to 1947. Changes took place with the economy and society. What was the economy in the past? What is the economy in the present? There are people, they did agriculture. In the agriculture, nowadays there are number of people who went to Bangalore, other cities, and they are doing the work in the industries. There are no industries in the past era. Society also fully changed. There was a superstitions, which means idol worship, and caste system, and a parada system, and next to sati system was practiced in the ancient days. Nowadays it has been reduced. We cannot see the parada system and we cannot see the sati system. It was banned in 1829 by William Bentinck, influenced by Raja Ram Mohan Roy. All these things happened over a stretch of time. It cannot be suddenly changed. We can only refer to a span of time, which means ಎಷ್ಟು ವರ್ಷಗಳು ನಡೆಯಿತು ಅಷ್ಟನ್ನು ಮಾತ್ರ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು. ಒಂದು ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯವಿಲ್ಲ. ಆ್ಯನ್ ಅಪ್ರಾಕ್ಸಿಮೇಟ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ ಓವರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಬಿಕೇಮ್ ವಿಸಿಬಲ್. ಯಾವುದು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ನಾವು ಅಪ್ರಾಕ್ಸಿಮೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಹೊರತು, ವಿ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಫೈನ್ ಡೇ. ವೆನ್ ವಾಸ್ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಇಂಡಿಯಾ? ವೆನ್ ವಾಸ್ ದ ಡಚ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಇಂಡಿಯಾ? ವೆನ್ ವಾಸ್ ದ ಫ್ರೆಂಚ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಇಂಡಿಯಾ? ಓಕೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ one question. History is usually incorrect to fix precise dates to processes. Why? Because when was the national movement was started? Changes took place within the economy and society. All these things happened over a stretch of time. Bala dinagala idididave. We can only refer a span of time. Okay, what we have discussed, in this class. The first one is the historians fascinated with dates. What are the importance of dates? And next two, when was crowned, when was battle took place, when was battle taken place. These are all the things that we have covered. And next class we are going to discuss which dates are important. Thank you.